Ladies and gentlemen, welcome into the Ricky Smiley Morning Show and Dish Nation, the actual boss. A man who needs no introduction, but we're going to introduce him anyway, because some white people might have just got out of jail and need to know. Ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, Rick Ross. Hey!
What up?
You know, and I say that we didn't need to introduce you, but we kind of almost do, man, because like if no one's seen you in a minute, they haven't known about the grind that you've been on, man. You've lost somewhere upwards of 80 pounds?
Yeah.
Or is it more than that?
80 pounds. I'll leave it at 80. I ain't going to take no more free credit.
Do you feel lighter? You feel better overall?
Yeah, I feel better. Most definitely, I feel better.
Man, that's outstanding, man. Because a lot of people don't like really understand like how much that like affects their overall mood, their productivity and the whole nine. And you felt comfortable enough in your recent video, Money Dance, to even get on that daggone, what is it called? The hoverboard?
The hoverboard.
What was your learning curve on that?
You know, it took me two or three days before I really was smooth on it.
Yeah. Does anybody floating around the city got like some side footage? Are you taking an L on that, or did you stay flat the whole time?
No, I took one L. You're gonna take an L.
Yeah.
Was it dramatic?
You ain't realistic if you ain't take an L.
Exactly.
But the beautiful thing about it was there was two things that happened in my gym with the rubber mat on the floor, and it was a case of the battery dying.
Okay.
So it just cut off.
Oh.
So it wasn't as dramatic or, you know, it was, you know, it just cut off. So, of course, you lost the power to it, but it wasn't, you know, too crazy.
Yeah, like okay. Gary fell off of one of those things, and he made it worse because he was reaching for things as he fell. And
you can't reach.
Well, hell, nobody told
me I couldn't
reach.
Forward.
Just hold on. Just wait. Just let it do what it do.
Mm-mm. Man,
just enjoy the moment.
You got to step back off that thing too. You can't step forward trying to get off.
Yeah, but I wanted to file a lawsuit because nobody told me that.
Oh, honey, see that's so. You mess us up because when we be trying to get them for free from people, they be like, "Nah, you're gonna have to come here. We're gonna have to show you how to do it because it's a liability."
Give me some manuals to read, hell.
So, on top of all that, a lot of big things to celebrate. Black Market, you've announced that. Upgrade from Black Dollar, which is a solid mixtape, I might add, man.
Appreciate it. It was just time to get the streets what they wanted. That's what I did with Black Dollar. You know, they appreciated it. Now it's time for the real music.
Now, like, hip-hop is short attention span theater. Like, you fed the streets twice last year. Hood Billionaire, and also, was it God Forgives?
Mastermind.
Two solid pieces of work, man. Do you feel like one was more or less appreciated than the other?
Nah, I felt like, you know, Mastermind was most definitely a project that I created for just everybody with Rosé in mind. Mm. And Hood Billionaire was something that I really put together dedicated to the city of Memphis without telling nobody. Mm. You know, I was doing so much business in Memphis. I was getting a lot of support. I was doing so many things in the city. The city gave me a key. The mayor gave me the key to the city. I opened up, I believe, 5 franchises at the time. And so I just felt like it was so much history and so much dope music there. That's where the Elvis Presley Boulevard single comes from.
That makes a lot of sense.
That's when I put Yo Gotti on the record. I put K. Michelle on the record.
Memphis.
You know, Project Pat on the record. I just wanted to go get some people in. I didn't want to even tell nobody what I was doing, and maybe, you know, later.
See if they figure it out.
Yeah.
Are you the first people that you told that to?
I may have mentioned it once or twice.
Just lie, man.
Yeah.
Just lie, say we the first.
Just lie, say yes. Yeah.
You up top though.
Exclusive.
you up top.
Man, so in addition to that, man, like, you know, like hip hop is all about not really showing your hands, showing your cards.
Right.
You've been showing a lot of vulnerability lately, man. Congratulations on your engagement.
Yeah, man.
Most definitely. Thank you.
You know, it's tough for people to find love in this business, man. Especially, like, you know, you seem all in.
Yeah, I'm all in. That's how you got to be.
You sure should be. And it's good that as a man of your stature and of who you are, that you're showing love. Now, how do you pronounce Lyra? Lyra?
Lyra.
Lyra. Now, Lyra. And Lyra looks like she's in here. Hey, Lyra.
Hey, Lyra.
Now, you know, it's love, Rick. When you bring your woman around
on the end,
because, you know, men don't, and I'm just being real, black men just don't do that.
That's right.
Y'all don't show her.
You got to be a boss to do that.
That's right.
You're definitely a boss. So how did you propose to her? I mean, what was the proposal like? I mean,
show it to him, baby.
Come here, baby.
Me,
I need to see that spark.
Come here, baby. Let me see that stone, baby.
No, I need to see her ring, honey. She need to come over here first, then go back over there. Come here, baby.
Yeah, Gary's our diamond appraiser.
Yes, Gary is the diamond man.
Right. Ooh, baby, she got an oval shape. And baggage. All right, girl.
Wait, girl, can you hold it up for the Dish Nation camera? Can they zoom in on that? All
right, Rick.
Shout out to everybody with the 4K TVs. We're going extra HD right now. Oh, Rick got one, too.
So, Lyra, okay. So, in the words, honey, of Miss Beyonce, baby, you'll be rocking VVS stones, honey. But not Rick. How did the proposal take place? What made Lyra the one?
You know, she just real genuine with it.
And she seems wholesome, sweet and wholesome.
She most definitely that. And you know, when I met her, she just, you know, became somebody that I didn't anticipate even, you know, growing into, you know, billing with. And that's what it was. And it's just a certain time I'm at in my life, you know, certain things I'm seeing and going through. I'm just keeping it all the way solid right now. So you got to, reward that loyalty.
Yeah, because as you get older, you get wiser, honey. Every good man needs a good woman behind him, honey.
Oh, you got to have a...
Not behind him, beside him.
Well, beside him, behind him, in front of him.
We don't do that behind you.
Whatever, honey. You need that good woman right there and to balance you. Because, you know, y'all rappers, y'all get out there and y'all act wild and stuff and do all these crazy things, honey. So you need a good woman, and that's good, and I'm glad to see that she looks like you too.
And not to mention, her omelet's better than anybody's in the world.
Cook game on point.
Oh, next level.
All right,
you gotta start the day out with a balanced breakfast. So that's if she get the omelets good to go, man, you all right over there.
Oh man,
and
wonderful.
She must be cooking healthy for you because you're keeping your weight down. Yeah. You doing your thing, man.
No, I'm in good hands.
You're in good hands.
You still rocking those pairs?
That's what's up.
Yeah, I still rock with the pears.
I used to hate pears so much, man. I guess I ate like a series of bad ones. Like my whole thing with pears is like they didn't know if they wanted to be apples or peaches. They just seemed like a hybrid fruit. But one day I had a good ass pear. I guess it was organic, farm to store, and I was on board from that point on. Not like a bad experience where anything can ruin anything. Have you ever ate a plantain thinking it was a banana?
Yeah, no, that's bad. That's a bad experience.
Changes everything, man. So with that being said, man, new single, Chris Brown, Sorry.
New single, Chris Brown, Sorry. This one our most, you know, passionate joint. Shout out to CB. We shooting that video actually in 5 or 6 days. We going out to L.A. to kick it with him. Lyra will be starring in the video.
That's what's up. That's right. You give your lady her shine,
that's
baby. Right. That's it.
That's how we do it.
See, it's dope when you can keep everything in house. Like, you know, when your girl's
that's
so bad.
That's how that Double M been that way since, you know, we came up in the game.
But, you know, one thing I appreciate, like, you've used your house for more videos. You know, like, the average rapper can't use their house for their music video.
And I've only used 2 rooms so far, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, so, yeah, man, we like got parts in C yet?
Yeah. We got a lot to go.
Man, what's the electric bill like in a place like that?
I ain't gonna say it.
Don't say it because that's more than people make for 2 years.
It's crazy.
I ain't gonna even say it. But if you want to see, you know what it looked like, you could go to my Snapchat. You could go to Lyra Snapchat, Lyra_Mercer. If you got Snapchat, join her Snapchat right now, Lyra_Mercer, and you're gonna see some dope images.
Rick, I am just so impressed with you. You're such a nice guy, and I mean, it's nice that you're expressing love.
No, listen, he always been like that, even back in the day when I was rolling through the streets of Miami when this he was writing for, like, Trina, like, years ago.
Yeah.
Like, he's always been humble and sweet and kind, and it's so dope to see that you have never changed and you still got the same heart, you know?
I love
man,
that.
Much love. Ain't nothing gonna change.
Word up, man. And don't change the dial, man. We about to blast off this Rick Ross joint featuring Chris Brown.
Chris Brown, Breezy.
Breezy.
Man, you can set it up better than I can. Come with it.
Y'all already know, man. This is my new single, Sorry, featuring Chris Brown off my new album, Black Market, which is dropping in December. You heard me? It's the boss. You better keep it locked right here.
All right. Rick's Mad Morning Show, man. Rick Ross is in the building.
It's
new
the biggest
album,
boss.
Black Market. Yeah. November, we talking, right?
December, early December.
Okay, cool.
Early December, the new album dropping. If you don't have my new mixtape, Black Dollar, you could go get that online as well. You're going to get some good music, but we feeding the streets, and we really finna give them that A-game this December.
No doubt, man. Like, you seem like you've always dabbled in politics a little bit, you know, at least far as being aware. Are you following this upcoming election close at all? Is anybody you getting behind?
Nah, I ain't hear nothing that was really interesting to me.
Now, Rick, I read somewhere that you're trying to be part ownership of the Dolphins.
Most definitely, I've been interested in getting in just a small piece.
Yeah.
Don't get it twisted, y'all. Rosé don't want much, you know?
Rosé. Just a
yeah, you could give me, you could just give me, you know, and I just been interested because I believe I could bring a lot of energy and marketing to the table to represent, you know, our kind, you know, that I feel which is missing right now, you know. And I went and had a meeting with the Dolphins, and I actually, you know, it's just a lot of stuff, you know. It was positive energy, but you know, I haven't made any progress. You know, I went down and seen the Mercedes-Benz Stadium, Atlanta. Shout out to the team, the Falcons, took me down there. You know, showed me around. You know, we discussed a few things as well. They 5-0. Y'all 5-0 right now. Congratulations. Yeah. Shout out to ATL.
Awarded a few. Like, but the thing is, like, you know, like the fans here are very fickle. Like, they'll ride with it when it's doing well, but like, let them lose two games back to back. We got to do better.
There's blacks everywhere.
But hey, just so it doesn't sound crazy, remember, we're in Miami too.
Oh, we in Miami too?
Yeah, this is 70, so we're on a 99 jam. So,
Yeah, so. Congratulations to the Falcons being 5-0. Dolphins, you know, we just let our head coach go, which was well overdue, and I feel we finna rebuild and, you know, do what we do.
You like, you played some football back in the day, man. You still got some moves?
Man, I'm always gonna have some moves.
That's natural. If you could put together a rap football team, who's on that team? Who's your start? How many people? Like, pardon my ignorance. How many people on the field at one time?
11 to 12.
Okay, give me 6. You're playing flag football. Who's Rick Ross's flag football team with an occasional tackle? Who's on your team?
That's right.
You said me.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, they got Lyra. Lingerie football.
Yeah.
It's flag. She don't have to get tackled.
Lyra, she on the team.
Right.
I'm gonna need a receiver too. I may put Nelly maybe at one receiver.
Okay.
I may put Wale at another receiver.
Yeah, right. Wale got some go. He talks about it all the time. Yeah.
Most definitely. I may put Staley at quarterback.
All right.
Who else we got?
What's Gunplay doing?
I may put, Gunplay, he got to be a safety or something. He got to make sure, you know, he got to wreak havoc. Yeah.
And Omarion can sing the national anthem.
He going to most definitely sing the national anthem. And we may put him in the backfield.
Oh, he got some go too?
Oh, most definitely.
All right, man, you got a legit team.
How do y'all know all those positions? I'm like, huh? I don't know nothing about football.
I watch boxing and MMA. I was like, that's why I was like, yeah, what are your starting five? No, that's basketball. Never mind. I'll stick to what I know. Hip-hop, BT Hip Hop Awards came on the other night. Did you get a chance to check it out?
Yeah, he was there.
Yeah, I went to the awards.
What did you think of the Cyphers?
Anybody stand up? Cyphers was better than they usually be. I enjoyed the Cyphers.
Like,
it was 3 or 4 artists. I can't remember their names off the top, but I remember one actual clip, the heavyweight dude with the black tee, another heavyweight dude. I believe those first, you know, couple, it was a good vibe, though.
There was a few scrunch face moments, like the kid Joyner Lucas from Boston. He crushed
it. He murdered it.
RedMan.
Yeah. Oh,
RedMan,
yeah.
Of course.
Brother Shody still got it. Same thing with Keith Murray and Eric Sermon.
Which
that's Def Squad.
Oh, yes. Every day, all day. Which reminds me, I was listening to a recent Eric Sermon interview, and he said he actually, back when you was rapping under the name Teflon,
Teflon Don.
You guys was about to do some business together, man. And I saw that you actually did something on a mixtape that he dropped about a year or two ago.
Album. You know, he flew me out to New York. I was a young dude, flew me out to New York. I went out to Staten Island, stayed in his basement, recorded 5 or 6 records, you know, and just went from there. And actually, I bumped into RedMan when we had a party the other night at a mansion. Mm. And I told RedMan, I say, big homie, I never got the chance to tell you this, but you picked me up from the airport before.
Wow.
You took me by Branson. You rolled me by the Yankee Stadium for the first time by Branson.
You got that job?
I said, that's when the BMW trucks first came out. I said, you was in a white one. And he just was looking at me like, and I'm like, Sermon told you to come grab me. That was me, well.
That's what's sad. That just gave me goosebumps because people don't remember that kind of stuff. I'm sure he didn't, but being in the position that you were in back then, you kept it in your head.
That was RedMan.
Man.
You know, it's always like, you know, like what I like to call those Benny Blanco moments. You know what I'm saying? Never create a Benny Blanco moment where, like, you rub somebody such the wrong way that they come back later on in life and kill you. Like, you know, be cool and fair to everybody and, like, just so you can build more friends than enemies, man.
Right.
It's dope, man. He took you to get that Branson straight from the airport?
As soon as we landed. Took me to get the Branson and took me out to Long Island where Sermon was at.
And I bet you a lot of people listen, like, what the hell is the Branson?
Because I was just
that, that Branson is an impressive move, and you're just now getting picked up from the
you're
airport.
You're just going to have to Google that.
You're next level.
Like,
you're
oh
next
my
level.
God, yeah.
That's private reserve. That's top shelf. You know, if you love it, man. You know, get your mind right. You know, if you happen to love that record, Crumble and Nerd by Outkast, you may know what we're talking about.
Biggie put me on the Branson, yo.
Wow.
Yeah, man. That was my
dude.
You're going
to have to give me one of them classic Biggie stories later on.
I got so many.
Oh man.
See, and I hate that we live in a time where you guys didn't really coexist in the same rap universe. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, you know, like, you know, you, I mean, I know you get the comparisons all the time, man. And even the way you blessed that Nobody to Somebody Kills You record, it's just the way you was weaving in and out, man.
Ooh.
Like, it just, you know, like, damn it, man. Like, if just to hear Big and Rosé on a record one time, man, that would have just been dope, man. Like, if you could have did any record that he did with him, what record would you do?
That's
hard. Too many options.
It's too many. It's too many.
A Brooklyn's finest, though.
Ooh,
which y'all trading verses in and out.
Ooh, like short sleeves up bare arms. Oh, my bad.
With the grunts in between. Like,
they,
like short sleeves
they
up.
They ain't made them yet.
Oh, man, they ain't made them trying to push 700s. They ain't
made them yet.
When I heard that, I was like, that boy is next level.
Yes.
Man,
always
man. A series of what ifs, man. Like, there's so many dope what ifs. I was talking the other day, man, like, just how much doper the Niggas for Life album would have been if Ice Cube was on it, you know, on the NWA tip.
That was my squad too.
What, NWA?
NWA, that was that whole, you know, just the West Coast movement. Mm-hmm. That's what hit the South when I was youngest. That's what hit the South. The East Coast, it was the East Coast. Most definitely was respected for the lyricism, but even more so for the fashion.
Right. Mm-hmm.
The Gucci sweatsuits, the two ropes, and all that spilt down in Miami. So when you seen Luke and Two Live Crew with the ropes and the...
Big chains. Right.
Yeah. and that hardcore rapping came from that left side.
Yeah.
And that was, you know, Ice Cube played a big part of that. That No Vaseline record changed the game.
Scrunch face.
Yes,
first time you hit it. I was 11 years old with a scrunch face listening to No Vaseline.
That lets you know you could go against the odds. Right.
And win.
Because
I actually was concerned about Ice Cube, like, when he left the group. It's like, oh, man, what's he going to do?
Concerned wasn't even a word. That was my favorite guy. But it's like, you know, you at odds with N.W.A.
Yeah.
There's no way you thought he was going to get out of that.
Those dudes were like superheroes to us, like, as kids, man. And just to, like, you know, just see it break apart. But even that, did you see the movie?
I ain't get to see the movie yet. You know, I've been on home confinement, you know, other than being able to go to specific spots for work. And somebody offered me the bootleg, and of course, they was kicked out of the crib. I can't watch no bootlegs. I just wait. I'll be a little patient.
Yeah.
You know, that's pretty cool of you, because I was just about to order for you an Amazon Fire Stick with it on there. And now I'm going to retract
that.
No,
I'm going
to
just wait.
I want to get
wait.
The invite.
Yeah. I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait.
Nah, it's a solid movie, man. You're definitely in for a treat, man.
Yo, you still got the bowling alley in the crib?
Yeah,
we was over there. I've been at your house before. It was your house when it was Holyfield's, because, you know, JD lived right across the street.
Right.
So we used to be over there bowling and stuff. So I'm ready to come back since it's y'all house
all
now.
Love.
I need to go swimming in the Olympic-sized pool.
It's all love.
And all that.
It's all
with
love.
Some chicken wings on the side. When I come off my
lemon
diet,
pepper.
I need a whole lemon pepper platter, baby.
I got you, too.
Right.
So being on the whole home confinement thing from time to time, having to watch the game move from your headquarters, man, like, you know, what do you miss the most, you know, about just...
You know,
really-
just seeing the people and the people seeing you. That's what you miss the most.
Like,
that's what I miss the most.
What's the first place you
know,
gonna go party
because,
at?
Because, you know, just, you know, I had so many contracts for performances and, you know, just people just genuinely want to see you.
Mm.
You know, and that was the downside to it.
Like, when you get to...
When I get home, when I can really move the way I want to move, I'm going to Miami. I'm running wild for a day or two.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
I feel that, man.
I'm going to have Shorty with me. Lyra going to be with me. She going
to
be shotgun.
She needs to be with you to keep you in line.
Believe that. Believe that.
Is Lyra just as good on the hoverboard as you are now? Because you was moving pretty flawlessly, man.
She actually better than me on the hoverboard. Oh. I'm gonna give her a little credit.
That's what's up. She got a pink one.
Yeah, I'm going to give her a credit on the little hoverboard vibe. I forgot what color hers is.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Lex, what's up with them hoverboards? Ain't no new hoverboards to give away?
Where they at? I need them.
I just need one.
I just need one.
You talking about you got to swipe the card, though.
I'm at a point where I'll buy one because I have a bike.
Nah, we're going to work that out. I got you. I got you.
Well, I'm at a point, Rick. I need you to give me one.
I'm plotting the same way. So, you know, we're going to work it out.
Not mad at that.
That's crazy.
Like, with all the drama that comes with being in a position that you're in, being a label boss, being, you know, and just being in a rap game, there's a lot of BS that comes with that, man. What all could you do without?
I feel like it's what you allow to really touch your heart and your soul. You know, if as much business, as much work as I do, I'm not really stressed. You know what I mean? You know, if it's not based around me wanting to do more, if it's any pressure on me, it's because I want to do more. Mm-hmm. So if I go to sleep at 6 a.m. and jump back up at 9, it's just because I want to do more. It's not because of, you know, because everything I really, you know, put in place and, you know, it move at our pace now. That's what you work, you know, to get in position for, to be able to have everything move at your pace. And that's what it is. But I'm just one of those few dudes that will never have enough, you know, and love what he does. So I get up every day, you know, trying to plot something else.
I feel you.
Well, Rick, I'm going to ask a Barbara Walters question. Do you trust people?
Not many.
Great answer.
Trust is expensive.
It sure is, honey.
That's
it
why
sure
I asked the question.
You buy that with time.
Because you got a lot of stuff going on and you're doing a lot. And I know it's hard to trust people.
It is.
Yeah, it's not. It's really not nothing that's on my list that I need to require to do or nothing. Nah. You got your family and you know it. You know, and you know who they are. The ones you trust, you don't question.
That's right. No new friends.
Yeah, I got dudes on my team that I love, you know. Real dudes, real G's. If they walked up behind me right now and put a gun in the back of my head and clicked it, I say, clown, put it down and go get some Wingstop for me. You love me.
Right.
You my brother, and it's vice versa.
Right.
And they'll go get me a 50 platter. Damn.
Lemon pepper?
50 platter.
Yeah, maybe teriyaki. She'll be hating on my lemon pepper sometime.
Oh, Gina.
Do you do the strips or you do the actual wings?
I do the flats. I'm a boss.
See,
flats.
The flats
when
are
when you
everything.
Go in there and you say all flats, that's when they look up from the register up at you and they know you Jedi.
That's what I'm talking about.
But like, but what is your flat technique? Because it is hard to eat flats without looking like a cannibal. Whenever I go to a club, the wings are open, and I see somebody in a corner eating a flat.
Now they got to be semi-tender. I'm going to explain
the beauty of a flat.
All right. Tell them, Rick.
The beauty of a flat, it originated from a young hustler who went and got him a hot 10-piece, jumped back in the car, pulled into traffic, used that one hand to pull that pack out, you pop the top of the wrench off, you see, you grab one end of the flats, you touch that thing on both sides with that wrench, still driving, everything good. Soon as you get any pause in the whip and you pull it, you know what I mean?
So you put the entire flat in your mouth and pull it out?
And pull the two bones out.
And the two bones come out.
And that's all that's left,
and then you just throw that in the bag.
I'm going to screw it up. It's going to be cartilage and that little weird.
Nah,
little
I'm just giving y'all a game. That's Jedi game for wing lovers.
I'm going to practice quietly. I'm not going to practice in the car. I'm in Atlanta.
That.
Things will go wrong.
Ain't
people
mad
think
at
that's
that.
Sexually suggestive. I'm good.
If you're a wing
not
lover, crack,
not
you will already know that.
Mm-hmm. Nah, see, I like wing spots. When you order a wing, it's the wing and the flat together. That's a wing to me.
No,
like,
all flats.
Nah, that's chicken.
Right.
It's a difference.
Right.
Yeah, it's a difference. It's a difference from wings and chicken. Yeah. And I'm a wing man, and I break it down like that. Word. I love chicken, just period, but give me the wings.
A
little bit of hot sauce in that ranch. It's just a life-changing
make it
moment.
Look pink.
Rick Ross, you came through. You gave us a lot of game just now.
You know I know what it is, bro.
It's time for the lightning round, my brother. Go throw some questions at you. You say the first thing that, you know, bounces back to you.
The steaks over there, bro.
What's the last movie you really liked?
American Sniper.
I heard that's good. I still haven't seen it yet.
Yeah.
All right.
Rest in peace. Shout out Chris Kyle, man.
Man, what stood out to you about the movie?
You know, just the storyline. You know, it was a real soldier going out. You know, he put his life on the line. anybody that's willing to sacrifice their life for something they believe in, you got to salute that.
Hear that?
And he went out and he put in work.
If you could do a buddy movie, like a ride along 48 hours trading places, something like that, with any other rapper in the game, who would you do it with?
With any other rapper in the game?
Yeah, like a comedy.
A comedy joint?
Yeah, because low key you're a funny dude, but you also could bring the action.
Yeah, I could shut it down. If I could, it'd be an honor. I'd say Andre 3 Stacks.
Yeah. A lot of people go to him. Like, when I say, who could you do a movie? Yeah. He's funny as hell.
And he's a great actor, too.
Not only, yeah, a great actor. So, you know, it'll actually be something that's dope.
I ticket that. If there's a Rick Ross biopic, who plays Rick Ross?
I don't know who could play Renzel.
We gotta
do a lot of auditioning for young Renzel. Right.
See,
the ambition gotta be coming out his pores.
Yeah, and then like the tat game gotta be on point. Like, what's the last tattoo you got?
Maybe her name.
Oh, the joint on the forearm, right?
No, somewhere over here mixed in with, you know.
The way they took the picture, I couldn't tell where it was.
Yeah, something like that.
Where? What tattoo hurt the most?
I really love the, you know, I love the pain.
So at no point, like even on your first tattoo, you didn't like cringe or go ow or anything? Like, you was all in from
my
day
first
one?
Tattoo, we was all on the porch. It was dark. I was late for being home. I was 13. I got a dollar sign.
Word?
Yeah. You either could get a dollar sign or a martini glass.
There was it like one guy doing all of those? Or?
Yeah. That's all he could do. So you had to pick, and you ain't have no olive. So, I'm going to go with the dollar sign, fam.
So if you could make a guesstimate, how many people are walking around Miami right now with a dollar sign or a martini glass on them, how many would you say?
Thousands and thousands and thousands.
Is the guy still alive that was doing them?
It's a good question. He went to prison many, many, many years ago.
There's probably people getting out every year. They got dollars and martinis.
No, that was just something that was in Miami that was, it went next level. The martini glass and the dollar sign was just early. You know, I was a youngster, but all the OGs, that's all they had.
Fresh. What's your worst habit, personally, you feel?
My worst habit? I got a couple of them, but I'm going to just go with, just controlling my patience. I'm going to use controlling my patience. I like putting that together.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I like that.
All right. What's the thing you get in trouble for the most by your fiance?
Uh-oh. I don't really get in trouble a lot. Aww. We was in Magic City the other night. She just whispered something at me, but she was smiling, so that's my baby.
I was talking to a producer that said he ran into you at Magic City, a guy named Brainiac. He's here from Denmark, like peddling beats, man. He's pretty dope, man. If you ever come across him, man,
yeah, shout out to the homie who peddling them beats, you heard me?
Word up. Now, the last question I got for you, and it's probably the most important question you'll be asked probably this month. What R&B song can you sing like you wrote it?
I'm going to go back to the Biggie record with R. Kelly. You tonight.
Now, if I pulled up the instrumental, could you sing R. Kelly's part and maybe Brat could do Biggie's part?
You losing subscribers soon as I try, it's over.
Because the cool thing is, like, recently we had, what's my man, Michael Ealy came through, and his joint, his go-to joint was LL Cool J, I Need Love. He bodied it.
Mm. He did.
Videos is popping.
You know, that was one of them joints, though.
What, I Need Love?
Yeah, that was one of them joints back in the day.
Do you think you could do it better than Michael Ealy did it?
I don't think I could remember it all the way. If it was playing, I may be able to, you know.
Shoot, we just need the first eight bars.
Sing along.
This is our celebrity karaoke battle.
Drop your
Wi-Fi battling Michael Ealy. You can jump in whenever you want.
When I'm alone in my room, time staff. In the back of my mind, I hear the conscious call telling me I need a girl who's as sweet as a dove. For the first time in my life, I see I need. There I was, riding in that big wheel race. Through the city, baby, call the county a date. I had Lyra with it, running.
Yo, Ray, that's a record. hard.
Oh, man, you would make it super hard. Yeah, bro.
Hey, y'all, yeah.
Got some record, dog. No, for real. Like,
hey, y'all plotted that right before we walked in.
No,
stop.
You want to know what my original plan was?
I wanted you to sing It's Driving Me Out of My
Mind. I wanted you to sing Ricky Bell's part on Poison because, like, your voice is so deep. I was like, man, if I get that deep voice, dude, to sing that Ricky Bell part on Poison, man,
that'd be next. Lyricist, do it. Come on,
can you do it? Yo, I'll do Ronnie's part. I'll do Ronnie's part if you do Ricky part, bro.
Go first, set it off. Let's go.
Uh-oh.
Young Coco in the building.
One of the greatest records of all time, made by some dudes from Boston, and we'll get to it after this YouTube ad.
Was the night before Christmas and all through the borough.
Here we go.
Girl, I must warn you.
Okay.
I said something strange in my mind.
Hey, Sam, come here. I need you up here.
Serious dessert, cause we're running out of time.
Check.
Crazy.